Good day everyone, Cass here, and today we are covering an exciting new feature on Oculus Quest called apelab. This was released just yesterday and is a new way for developers to distribute apps directly to us, the consumers, via direct links. This means that you can easily install games or apps that are not on the Quest store just by getting a link. This is like a new way to sideload, in quotes, because it's not exactly sideloading and it probably won't replace it completely either. There are benefits and disadvantages which I'm going to explain in this video. I'll also explain how to use apelab, we'll talk about its features, and we're going to talk about SideQuest's role in this and its future. If you'd like to see more videos like this one, consider subscribing as that's a big support to us, and now join me beyond reality. So the apelab feature is part of the new Quest software update version 25. It adds many improvements which I will cover later, but today I wanted to cover the biggest and best feature added, which is apelab. It's exciting as it allows a much easier and accessible way to play games not available on the Quest store. But it's not unlimited, so let's talk about its advantages and disadvantages. First, it's more accessible as games on apelab won't need developer mode or sideloading anymore. It's easier to find these games as they appear in your library instead of the hidden unknown sources. However, developers still need to go through an approval process. There are still requirements, but it is more flexible for developers than getting the game on the normal Quest store. For example, games like Ancient Dungeon VR were only playable via sideloading, but now available via apelab. So it is certain that we will get a lot more interesting games to play, but since there is still an approval process, there could still be games not available via apelab, so then sideloading on SideQuest is still the way to go. But only time will tell how strict Oculus will be exactly. So then, what is SideQuest's role in all of this? Well, I occasionally chat with Shane, the developer of SideQuest, and he has told me that they have been working closely with Oculus on all this. SideQuest also rolled out a feature that allows developers to add an apelab URL to SideQuest. This means SideQuest will act as a directory for the apelab games, which is excellent news for developers as SQ already has a huge reach, but also great for us as there is one place to find all these games, kind of like a Google, especially for these Quest games. Plus, if there are any unapproved games, then you can still use SideQuest to sideload. If you don't know how to sideload, by the way, I made a guide on this, the link is below. So I don't think SideQuest is dead, or that Oculus intends to take it over, which I hope will stay like that forever. Now, let me show you how to install games and apps with apelab. It's really simple, all you need is the link from a developer. I've linked a couple of examples in the description below, or you can go on SideQuest and find apelab games there. To recognize if a game is from apelab on SideQuest, you will see this button, Oculus App, instead of the button Install to Headset. This is the link you will need. Then just open the link in a browser. You will get a message that this is an app available through apelab, so that the game is experimental or in development. Just click OK here. Then make sure you are logged in and then click the blue button. Some apps are free, some apps are paid, but this is the same process as with any app. If you paid for the app or if it's free, the blue button will disappear, meaning that a request to install was sent to your Oculus Quest. Now, if you put on your Quest, the app will show up in the app's library with a little concept deck on the thumbnail indicating an apelab game. I noticed that this may take a minute sometimes though, but once it shows up, you can install and play the game like you usually do. So the best thing about this is you don't even need a PC for this anymore. You can also do all this within Oculus Quest itself by going to the link via the Oculus Quest browser and then doing the same steps. Or open the link via your phone, that also works. But there's another added benefit, and that is that apelab games have access to regular Quest game features. Like I already said, it shows up in your gallery, but these games also get automatic updates, for example. It also adds more accessibility, as you can also search apelab games in the search field inside your Quest. You do need to fill out the exact name, but then you can find the game in the apelab section of the search results. Now, this only shows up if you're on update 25 though, but don't worry if you don't have that yet. I don't either. Like always, this is rolled out gradually by Oculus, so we should all get it in a few days. To check if you have it, go in your Quest, go to Settings, General, then About. Here you can see what software version you are on, and if the update is available to you, you can install it from there. Like always, there is a way to manually update this once the firmware is available. You can keep an eye out for this on this Reddit page, but do keep in mind this may cause problems with your Quest, so I always recommend waiting just to be sure. Now, if you want to know how to find the games now, I suggest checking out SideQuest. Right now, SQ does not have a filter for apelab specific games, but I spoke to the SQ dev about this and he said he's going to add that, so that's going to be nice. There's also a Reddit page available that will be updated with apelab games as they show up. I also linked some apelab games down below in the description for your convenience. So, let me know what you think of this feature, and if you have some apelab recommendations yourself, put them down below as well. Thanks for watching. I hope you'll watch more to support us, and a special thanks go to all our champions, especially these champions down below. And as always, VR on!